11 local food truck owners say they're scrambling after they were hit by a suspected drunk driver. Now their truck is damaged and they tell us they can't work again until it's fixed. 8 News Now anchor Sasha Loftus joining us live downtown with more.
Denise and Brian, this is the intersection where those food truck owners say they were hit a few weeks ago. You can see there's another food truck here tonight. Now, while they say they were grateful to walk away from this, the two tell me this whole situation has turned their world upside down.
Out of nowhere, we got hit from the backside of the trailer.
A normal night on the job takes a terrifying turn for Blake Wright and Desiree Evangelista.
Then we realized, like, man, what just happened?
The two were working downtown in their food truck, Hibachi Done Right, exactly, when they say a suspected drunk driver slammed into them.
And then upon impact, I mean, we didn't expect it, so we just completely flew into what was in front of us.
Though they weren't seriously hurt, Blake and Desiree are now left with at least $20,000 in damage.
Ripped the door off of one of my refrigerators on impact, broke the bracket of another one.
And as they wait for the investigation and their insurance claim, the couple doesn't have a source of income.
I was out working and, you know, trying to support my family like everybody else. You know, wake up, go to work, and in a blink of an eye, it was taken away from us.
That's why they're asking the community for help.
Just something to get us through till insurance can pay out.
As they also work to process what happened and the fact that things could have been much worse.
Damage can be repaired, but a lost life can't be brought back.
Now, Blake and Desiree say in addition to the damage their truck had and all the appliances inside it, they did lose almost all of their food, and that is quite pricey, of course. If you'd like to help, they do have a GoFundMe up right now. Reporting live downtown tonight, Sasha Loftus, 8 News Now.
Sasha, thank you. Now, Blake and Desiree only had their food truck business for about 5 months when this happened. They're hoping to get it back up and running in time for the holidays.